Is it what I think is in this box, Gordon?
It is, actually. It is finally the long-awaited, much-hyped, highly anticipated Ryzen 3rd generation parts. This is the reviewer's kit that some people are getting. Some people are getting a different setup because they're getting GPUs as well. I don't think I'm getting the GPUs.
Our GPUs went to Brad.
I'm interested to see what the retail box looks like because they haven't talked about the retail box. I'm thinking it'll be the old-fashioned paper stuff. All right, so are we going to even get retail here is what I want to know. We get our very nice special box from AMD. The company's been really good about sending this to reviewers. This is not a retail box for this. Let's see what's in here. Voila. Ah, okay. So there is new packaging. Let me grab an old one. This is a box for a Ryzen 7 2700X. Came with a Wraith cooler with the RGBs. This was probably an 1800X box because there's no heatsink with that one. But we get two chips. One is the Ryzen 7 3700X, 8 cores, SMT. Comes with a cooler. There's the CPU itself. I'm sure you're happy to see that finally. And we'll actually unbox the CPUs. People are going to want to see what's in here. 3700X, $329. 8 core, 7 nanometer. Looks like you get, yeah. It is a Wraith RGB, I believe. Yeah?
I love it. Love the RGB.
And of course, for CPU, you get your CPU sticker. This hasn't changed much. And of course, the CPU looks very much similar to the 2700X. Right, the other excitement though is this baby, the Ryzen 9 3900X.
That's a little bigger box,
a little bit bigger X box. You get a little more, look at that. So you're getting premium boxing, not quite Threadripper, but
still pretty nice.
Pretty nice. Same packaging here as the 3900X. And let's see what cooler you get. People love these things. People love the coolers here. They actually did tell us. It's basically a same cooler. So we also are getting for our testing, two motherboards. There are four motherboard options they sent out. This is MSI's Meg X570 Godlike. This is pretty much one of the top tier boards that MSI is making. Ain't gonna be cheap.
We saw at Computex, right?
We saw that at Computex. There's a second motherboard. ASUS Crosshair 8 Hero Wi-Fi. I don't know how you open this. I know people will get angry if I rip it.
There you go. Don't rip it.
Now, there you go. X570. I believe on the Godlike, if I got this right, MSI did say for the M.2 slot, that is Gen 4, that goes directly to the CPU socket. It is actually on the bottom M.2 slot. They decided that they didn't want it sitting underneath the video card. One is thermals. Two is I don't think it'll fit because the other very exciting thing in this box, if we can find it, is this. The obviously not retail box, unless it's going to be generic, but is a Corsair MP600 Gen 4 PCIe SSD.
Nice.
Let's see what the final packaging look like as far as the heatsink goes. I don't think it would fit in most motherboards, so we're going to assume that the SSD is the same, even though this clearly is not final retail packaging. So I'm not going to worry about the box here. Let's get it out. Pretty big, right? A good size heatsink, or I guess, and it is dual sided. It is a Phison controller, and of course we saw these at Computex all over the place, pushing 5 gig reads, right? And the cooler on the Gigabyte is even bigger.
Wow.
So you're going to need it. What else we got? G-Skill memory. One of the big improvements to Ryzen 3000 is way better memory clocks. The kit they gave us is 3600.
Which I think they've said, oh, whoa.
Ooh, the Royal. So everybody loves these because it's just got that.
Got the RGB and...
got the kind of
the bling,
the diamond bling look. Ooh. When you light it up. It looks quite pretty.
Yeah.
2 8-gig DIMMs. DDR4 3600, and look, you get a polishing cloth. Very classy,
love
very
it.
Classy.
Love it.
I think that's everything. What else? Yeah, that's everything we get.
tell us what our plans are for testing with these.
So, this is basically we have about 4 days before the 4th of July, which in the United States is a huge holiday. I'm unfortunately going on vacation, but we are going to try to get as much testing done as much as possible before the deadline for this video can go. 7.7, of course. We'll be comparing it against a 2700X. In fact, I have two builds going in the background. I don't know if you can hear the fans or not. 2700X right there. We're using HADI coolers on both of them, Corsair coolers. There's a 9900K down there. I'm doing MCE off, PBO off, PBO on. Bunch of testing now. We will try to get as many tests to you as soon as possible, but also anticipate on Monday.
Yep.
Probably because we don't have quite the time to do the in-depth testing we would normally do if there wasn't a holiday in the middle of all this. We will also look at results from other sites. So we'll try to summarize what other reviewers are seeing, how they're receiving this product. Does it live up to the hype is the question. I think everybody sort of expects it to, because even Intel itself today, the news was they admitted, like, oh my God, AMD's got a real product here. We got problems. I want to see it for myself. I still don't believe it until I get the thing running. But we'll see what Gamers Nexus, PC Gamer, everybody else out there, they're testing it on Tom's Hardware. I want to see what they're going to say on deadline. We'll summarize it for you. Come back after this video to see that one.